Hello, welcome back. I wanted to do a quick video on how to keep rabbits cool in the summertime. So specifically where I live, the summer times around here can get all the way up to 100, 110 degrees. And obviously, if you've been raising rabbits for a while, you know that that can be deadly to your animals. So I brought this little squirt out today to say hi for the video. He's one of the more recent baby bunnies. You may have seen him in one of my previous videos. But he's not going to be doing much. He's just here to say hi. So first thing you can do is put them in some sort of a enclosure. So as we've spoken before, a lot of rabbits, we have wire cages, which is fantastic, especially in the heat, because this is going to allow for a lot of airflow, a lot of circulation. Hi, boy. He's saying hi. But it allows for a lot of that circulation within the barn. And that's why you'll see a lot of people who have barns, because it helps maintain and regulate the temperature. Oh, come back around and say hi. Maintains and helps regulate the temperature. Now this barn, on the other hand, as you can see, ooh, that's a spider web. It's a metal shed, which is kind of counterintuitive to wanting to maintain a little bit colder environment in here for the baby bunnies. But what you can do, whether you are in a barn or outside of a barn and you have them outside in a hutch or something like that, you can utilize what I have right here. A frozen water bottle. You can buy those big two-liter jugs from like the dollar store or something. When I used to keep all my animals outside, I would buy as many of those that could fit into a freezer. And I would purchase them, stick them in the freezer, and then I would change them out about once a day. Once or twice a day, depending how hot it was. But that can be quite inconvenient, so thankfully I've been able to kind of upgrade my rabbits' lives and living situations. So I actually no longer use these anymore. The reason why this is frozen is because now I use little water bottles for like my coolers. So when I go camping or something like that. So that's the reason why I have this. It's because I actually use it for ice in the cooler instead of having to go buy some. Now, what I actually use currently, oh, there you go, little buddy. Again, I have a metal shed, which does keep it relatively cooler outside. I actually have a tree behind this wall here that helps shade and helps continue keeping everything a little bit cooler. However, what I have been able to do, this is Lulu, by the way, what I have been able to do is purchase this swamp cooler. So for lighting purposes, I'm not going to close the doors, but I will actually close these doors here all the way to where there's very little escaping air. And all I have to do, this one's broken currently, so I do need to get a replacement, but, and it can be pretty loud, but I just turn it on, and even in 100 degree temperatures, it works fabulously. Now, if it gets above 100 degrees, I will probably end up grabbing some ice bottles and throwing them in their cages, especially in the evenings. However, this swamp cooler does such an amazing job at keeping this barn cool in the summer times that I usually don't have to worry about it. But yeah, if you guys have any other tips and tricks, please comment them below for people watching. I know a few of the tricks that I've heard from 4-H'ers and stuff like that is if you have an outdoor hutch, you can also place a wet towel over the hutch, and it helps kind of perspirate and evaporate that water off, keeping it a little bit cooler. Again, not a very long-term solution. However, it will help. And as you know, in the summertime, any little bit helps to keep your animals alive. So good luck, and I hope you guys have a fantastic day. Thanks for watching. Bye.